Hey Sand Freaks, welcome. So today I've got an exciting video. We have an unboxing and first impression of Guerlain's Coconut Fizz. Now I know or I've heard that this is a discontinued fragrance. However, I was able to purchase a bottle and I have seen it on certain online fragrance retailers as well as even some stores. So don't give up hope. If you do want to try this fragrance or you know you love it and you want another bottle, keep your eye out because it is out there. Don't forget to subscribe and hit notifications if you like my content. Now let's get started. Okay, so the box is presented like this. It's just kind of a white cardboard box. Let's crack it open. I'm so excited.
A few moments later.
Okay guys, so I'm about to crack it open and I have never smelled this fragrance. I've heard about it and it being like the ultimate coconut fragrance. So I love coconut fragrances, so I'm so excited to actually smell this for the first time and see what all the hype is about. Oh my goodness, I love Guerlain bottles too. I can just tell, oh my gosh, look at that. Look how beautiful that bottle is. It really is quite unique as well. Look at it. Okay, so the moment we've been waiting for, let's spritz this baby and see what it's all about. Okay. To start off with, it is definitely coconut, like obviously. But it is definitely a different kind of coconut. Okay, so some of the fragrance notes in this fragrance are coconut nectar, freesia, bergamot, sandalwood, and tonka bean, which, I mean, that combination sounds very lush. It sounds quite tropical, but also creamy and sweet. It definitely has a genuine vibe to it. Like, you know how sometimes you get coconut fragrances that are quite artificial smelling? They don't really smell like authentic coconut. Well, this is not the case with this one. This is more like a coconut pulp. That watery, very genuine, natural, non-artificial coconut. It actually reminds me of some sort of tropical, luxurious, high-end sunscreen, but at the same time, it's light, it's airy. I would imagine it's easy to wear. It also smells very fresh and clean. So for you clean, fresh folk out there, you guys will probably really like this fragrance if you enjoy coconut as well. Now, I know with a name like Coconut Fizz, that it would be quite light and airy. My concern would be, even though I actually really like the scent at this point in time, that it being so watery, that the projection and longevity of this fragrance may not be ideal. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to leave it on the test strip for a few hours. I cannot wear it on the skin as I already have a fragrance on and I don't want them to compete. So I will come back in a few hours time and tell you how it's dried down and any further thoughts I have. So it won't be long for you guys, but it'll be a few hours for me anyway.
Later that same evening.
Okay guys, I'm back. So it's been round about the 4.5, maybe 5 hour mark since I sprayed it on the test strip. So what I've noticed with this fragrance as it develops is that it doesn't really change that much. It stays very, very genuine to coconut. It's more of a fleshy coconut. It's not too sweet, not too cloying, and it would definitely be very easy to wear. It is so not artificial smelling, which, let's face it, with a lot of coconut fragrances, they are quite hardcore and they are very coconutty, artificial scented. So what I think the ideal wear time for this fragrance would be is that this is a fabulous summer fragrance. It's almost the epitome of summer fragrances. You could literally spray this without even thinking about it on a hot summer's day, walk out the door and smell delicious. I also think that this fragrance would serve really well as a layering fragrance. Now, some people layer, other people don't. I've recently started layering, and obviously being an unboxing first impression, I haven't layered this with anything yet, but I could think of a few fragrances I have that would go really, really well with this. Only being that I think being that watery, pulpy coconut, that it's not going to give you that long-standing projection and longevity. Even on the test strip here, it's still very, very watery. I think it would become a skin scent, you know, within an hour or so of you spritzing it. But layering it with a, you know, more of a tropical summer or gourmand fragrance, it might be a match made in heaven. Now, smelling it on the test strip here, I'm thinking to myself, and even throughout the day, I've kind of ducked in and kept smelling it to really get an idea about how it's drying down. But in all honesty, from initial spritz even till now, it's kind of stayed the same. It hasn't really developed into anything different. On the flip side of that though, I don't believe that the longevity and projection of this one would really cut it for me personally. The way that I look at it is that if I'm going to spend hundreds of dollars on a fragrance, she better last. And if she doesn't, then, oh well, you know, I'm not going to repurchase that fragrance. In saying that, yes, I think this would serve as a great layering fragrance. I think initially, at least for the first hour, it would really smell, you know, awesome with some of my other fragrances. But I think, again, that you're spending so much money on a bottle of fragrance, it really should just stand in its own right. Now, this fragrance, though, is absolutely beautiful. The spritz is so fresh, clean, refreshing. It's very coconutty. And I suppose it's very true to its name, Coconut Fizz, which is exactly almost what I smell. I mean, I would have actually probably called it coconut water, as it has that coconut water vibe rather than that creamy, delicious coconut. But I think that that's an example of how this fragrance has managed to stay very genuine to coconut itself. It's not trying to pretend to be coconut. This is genuine, juicy, watery coconut pulp in a bottle. So to sum it all up, I really enjoy this fragrance. I think it's really lovely, fresh, and unique. I think I love the fact that it stays genuine to actual coconut. The only thing that I have a problem with this fragrance is the longevity and projection of it. I can tell that it is not going to last long and that it's really just going to become a skin scent after a quite short amount of time. If it was at a different price point, then I would definitely have it as a staple. Like I'm talking maybe $50, but at $200, I just could not justify repurchasing this fragrance for that price point. If any of you out there are really fresh, clean scent people, and that's what you look for in a fragrance, and you also enjoy coconut, but light, airy, fresh, clean coconut, please check out this fragrance. I think that would be right up your alley. For anybody else that's looking for a hardcore coconut, tropical, long-lasting fragrance, this one is probably not for you. In saying that, it smells absolutely beautiful, but as I said, I just do not think that the price is justified. Okay, scent freaks, so that is the video. I hope you guys enjoyed the unboxing and first impression today. If you guys own this fragrance or have any comments or feedback regarding this, please post it in the comments below. I would love to hear from you, and I hope to see you next time. Take care, guys. Bye.